Hello everyone, I'm Amanda and this is Big Empress Energy. I am here to do a general April reading for all those concerned with Gemini. So Gemini could be your sun, moon, or rising signs. Your Venus could be in Gemini, or just any other important placement in your chart. Or you could be connecting with a Gemini, and if that's the case, just be aware that you might have to flip the roles. And if this reading resonates with you, please like and comment. And if you like the way that I read, please subscribe to my channel. Every little bit helps me so much. I am just starting out as a channel, so every view, every comment, every like, every new subscriber, I get really excited about and means so much to me, and it really does help. Wow, Gemini, okay. Sorry, and I also wanted to say that, I'm just redoing a couple of the monthly Zodiac readings because I am working with new equipment, and some of them were, woo, cool. Oh no, Gemini. Some of them were really hard to, hear. This is intense energy, Gemini. Yeah, sorry, I'm redoing some of them because the sound quality wasn't fantastic, so yeah, and I want you guys to be able to hear the messages that I pick up on, so here we are, Gemini. Some pain involving love, here, Gemini, or you know, connections, relationships in some way. I see that, you know, because of that hurt, it's caused you to look inward and to try to heal. Yeah, but I do see that you're coming out on top. You're overcoming it with the Six of Wands here, Gemini. This is also it. Ooh, Page of Wands. Yeah, okay. One more, please. The Magician. Wow, Gemini, this is you. You're showing up in your energy. Very cool. So you have Virgo here twice, Gemini. The Hermit is Virgo, and then the Magician is a Mercury card. So it is both signs ruled by Mercury, which is you, Gemini, and Virgos. Wow. So some of you could be dealing with a Virgo, for sure. Okay. Sorry, let me get these in the right positions, because I'm really anal about my about my card placements. And a bunch of other stuff. Okay, so bottom of the deck is the Six of Pentacles. So you have the Six and Seven of Pentacles. You're leveling up, Gemini, for sure. Leveling up in life. Leveling up in your things in your physical reality. That could be your health. That could be your finances. That could be your career. But you're progressing. Even through all this heartbreak that I see here. Very, very cool energy, Gemini. I see that you're learning. I see, you know, the hermit and the Three of Pentacles both represent learning, you know. The Hermit is really, you know, going inward and solitary kind of learning. But the Three of Pentacles, you know, is training, is learning, other people teaching, you know. You could be teaching or you could be learning, Gemini, but obviously that's not going to be all of you. But I do think that, you know, this progression through life that I'm seeing here, this progression through different elements of your life is teaching you really important lessons, Gemini. I would also like to say you have two pages or daughters in this deck. You have two threes and you have two sixes. So, you know, I see whoever or whatever situation you were dealing with, Gemini, I see a lot of mirroring happening there. And with the infinity symbol, this could have been a twin flame, Gemini, with the Two of Cups here. I'm inclined to believe this could have been it's not going to be all of you, of course, but I'm inclined to believe that this could have been a twin flame separation with the Three of Swords. But yeah, Gemini, I see you, like, finding balance again, after some really painful circumstances. And I see you working to forgive, people or situations that have hurt you. You're what I see here at the very heart of this reading is the Seven of Pentacles, which is kind of a stillness. There's a stillness to the Seven of Pentacles, but it's really, I mean, the sevens, all of them are about assessment. So I see you kind of, you know, taking it all in, all of the things that you've experienced in you know, recently for you, you know, the end of last year, beginning of this year, leading up to April. You're kind of taking in everything that has changed, all of the pain and you know, the painful lessons, all of it. And you're in hermit mode right now, or you are just now coming out of hermit mode, Gemini. So what I mean by that when I say that is really going inward, and you know, distancing yourself from others, not in a bad way, in a way that you can find forgiveness, you can heal, you can assess the, you know, everything that's happened this far. You know, every time I've had a Three of Swords energy, which for me, that was the end of last year, Gemini. You know, every time I have felt my heart break, I tend to go into that hermit mode. And I think a lot of people do, Gemini. So what I see here is, you know, you've experienced some heartbreak. It's probably going to be in love for a lot of you, but it could be, you know, with these pentacles, it could be health. With the wands, it could be, you know, things that make you feel passionate, you know, just disappointment and heartbreak in circumstances in our life, you know. It could be loss, it could be, like, grief. It could just be, you know, a feeling of having been betrayed, or, you know, people that we care about talking behind our back, those kinds of things. But with the Daughter of Cups and the Daughter of Wands sandwiching this Three of Swords here, Gemini, I see, you know, you are trying to balance this out. You are trying to heal and forgive. And it's really beautiful energy. But this month, I see you, you know, taking it all in, assessing it all. But what's coming towards you, Gemini, because you've gone into hermit mode, because you are assessing and trying to heal and trying to learn from everything that's happened and trying to forgive, you are coming out on top. I mean, with this last row is incredibly powerful energy. You have the Six of Wands, which is, you know, overcoming difficulties. This butterfly is, you know, rising above all of these wands, all this difficulty here. In the traditional Rider-Waite, the Six of Wands is that man, you know, he has a wreath on, I think it's on his staff, and he's trotting along on a horse, and there are other wands and people celebrating him. And then the Magician is very powerful energy. The Magician has everything that he needs to manifest the reality that he wants. And the Page of Wands is, you know, creative pursuits. It's what sparks your fire. It's being curious. And it's a willingness to explore, Gemini. And I see, you know, I'm taking that, interpreting that as you coming out of this hermit mode and wanting to try again, but in a better way this time. So if it was love that hurt you, you know, I see you, you know, healing from that. You've been healing from that. You assess the situation, you try to learn the lessons, and then I see you overcoming it all and going out there and exploring new kinds of love. If this was, you know, health struggles, you have physically been healing. For some reason, this is not going to resonate with all of you. It's probably only going to resonate with one of you, if that, but my guides are giving it to me, so I am giving it to you, Gemini. For some of you, you have been having heart struggles or heart problems, or maybe issues with your blood or circulatory system, vascular system in some way. But you have been going through healing for that, and you have healed. You are, you know, you are still in the process of healing right now, but you're coming out of that stronger than ever. So if you've been having health problems, Gemini, I'll just say that, you know, you're healing and you're coming out of it on top, healthier than ever. But for some of you, you know, it could have been finances, it could have been troubles in school, it could be a million things. It could be issues with your neighbor, It could be so many things. But what I see here, Gemini, is you fixing it. You assessing the situation, you're taking the lessons, you're leaving behind what didn't serve you, and you're making it into something new. You're the magician. You're manifesting something new with it. You're performing magic in real time, in real life, in your physical reality. It's really beautiful. And the only reason you're able to do that, Gemini, is because you've done the hard work. You've taken the assessment. You've learned from this pain. Yeah. And if you want new love, Gemini, if you're looking for love, I definitely see that coming in. You know, you've been in hermit mode, but with the Page of Cups and the Two of Cups, and the Magician and the Six of Wands and the Page of Wands, like you are getting attention. People are paying attention to you. They're being drawn to you. And you'll definitely have some love offers if that's what you want, Gemini. Okay, so you know, I'm gonna leave it there. I'm gonna go ahead and pull an oracle card for you just as advice for the month of April. For my Geminis, please. Advice for the month of April. Spirit guides and guardian angels are telling me that's it. Oh my God, Cancer got this card. I think. Did Cancer get this card? No, they didn't. This is interesting. I mean, I'm getting like devil energy here with the snake and the apple. It's number 19, so someone could be 19. 19 could be significant. 19 reduces to 10, which is endings, you know. Yeah. Okay, so sorry, I don't know why I thought Cancer got that card. Okay. So, wow. Oh my God. Gemini. At the very heart of this reading, what did I say sevens are? They're assessment, right? Listen to the keywords of this card. Contemplation, analysis, awareness. Man is the only animal for whom his own existence is a problem which he has to solve. Oh my God, I love that. That's very Alan Watts-esque, but it's from someone named Eric Fromm. Okay, so while we share common traits with all other living entities and are indeed linked to them in so many ways, our humanity is probably best defined by our awareness of ourselves. We alone can look up at the sky and contemplate our role in the universe. We alone have the freedom of choice and the capability of rational thought beyond survival and procreation. We alone can question relative values and choose right from wrong. Our consciousness is both a blessing and a burden. It provides us with the ability to ponder and question. More than any other living entities, we have the capacity to consider variables and options for the future and to be either encouraged or concerned about the possibilities. Okay, so while I was reading that, I'm sorry, I was trying to focus on the words, but my guides were telling me something that definitely ties into the meaning of this card, but they were giving me messages the entire time. So I was trying to focus, but okay, so the messages that they were giving me with this card, Gemini is so yes, you are assessing things, you know, you're in hermit mode and you're assessing things, but I see you having like trying to learn from your choices and experiences in the past. Like I with the Three of Swords and the Two of Cups here, twos can represent choices, you know, being at a crossroads, having to choose. And with this snake and the apple, I'm getting the Lovers energy here. Because that's on, you know, in the traditional Rider-Waite, that's on the Lovers card. So, and that's you, Gemini, that's your energy, that's your card. So what I see here, also let me say, the Lovers, used to be called the Choice, and it represents a really important choice and how that will affect the people in our lives, the people that we care about, the people that we love. So Gemini, I'm really getting that you have come from that crossroads moment, that choice. And now, you know, it's caused you to go inward and to think about how you feel and to look at, you know, how you can learn from that experience, and what you chose. And you know, you're in the assessment part of it now, Gemini. But what's coming in at the end of this month is you know, finally ready to start taking action. The Magician is action. The Page of Wands is action. The Six of Wands is action. The Six of Wands is succeeding in that action. So it's a very beautiful message, Gemini. But you know, for a lot of you, and it's not going to be for all of you, but for a lot of you, I see that choice having involved love. You know, you could choose to end things because the Three of Swords can really represent a painful ending in a relationship. You can choose to end things, or you can choose love. And I think you know, either at that crossroads now, Gemini, or you have been at that crossroads in the recent past, and you're now assessing your choices and getting ready, planning to take action in whatever direction you choose, Gemini. I mean, the Page of Wands can even represent travel, so maybe some of you are given the option to travel. Okay, Gemini, this was a really nice reading, very interesting energy, a lot of positivity and success coming in for you in the month of April and in the month of May after. Okay, Gemini, so if you liked this reading, if it resonated with you, please like and comment. And if you like the way that I read, please subscribe to my channel. I'd love to have you as a part of the family. And if you'd like a personal reading with me, Gemini, I'll put my email in the description box below. You can message me there just if you want to ask questions about what it would entail. I'll absolutely answer them. I love to do that. Okay, Gemini, so I will see you in the next one. I hope you have a great April, and I love you.